Hello everyone. In this tutorial, we'll demonstrate how to use heat maps, also known as tension, strain, or comfort maps, for clothing using uDraper in Unreal Engine. This feature is often used in virtual fitting room solutions and can be achieved using both uDraper and native UE materials. Let's start with the uDraper material system. By default, this feature is disabled as it can impact performance. However, you can activate it by following these steps. Enable Show Engine and Show Plugins Content. Scroll down and locate uDraper in the plugins, then navigate to Materials, Fabrics, Layers. Open the ML Wrinkles Material layer, where you'll find the MF Heat Map function on the left and two unconnected masks. Connect these pins to Emissive Color and Opacity, then save. That's it! Keep in mind that when you update uDraper, this wrinkles material layer we just modified will be reset to default, and the pins we connected will be disconnected. So if you plan to update the plugin, you'll need to repeat this step or save a copy of the material layer in your project folder. Now that we've got the heat map material ready, let's do a simple demonstration, although there are many ways to implement this using blueprints. First, let's create a blueprint and name it Heatmap Component. Then, we'll attach it to our Draper Garment component like this. Inside the blueprint, we'll add a custom event and call it Toggle Heatmap. Make sure to enable the call in editor options so that we can use a button to toggle the heat map during our demonstration. To make the heat map work, we'll need to add a few nodes. First, we'll add get attached parent and cast to Draper garment. Then, we can grab the heat map function and connect it to the flip-flop function so we can toggle it on and off. Finally, don't forget to compile and save your blueprint. Before we move on, let's open the Draper editor by clicking on the Edit button. Then, let's click Play to start the simulation. Once it's initialized, we can turn on the heat map and see the colors it uses to indicate areas of strain. The heat map colors are as follows. White, areas that are not stretched. Yellow, slightly stretched areas. Red, significantly stretched areas. Purple, areas that cannot be stretched any further due to their elasticity limit. In this example, we have a pair of jeans with two different materials, one for the waistband and one for the rest of the jeans. We can adjust the stretch resistance for each material to control the heat map effect. For instance, if we increase the stretch resistance for the waistband as if it gets stiffer, we'll see that the heat map color turns purple. This indicates that the waistband cannot be worn around the waist of the mannequin. Here's another example. These jeans are available in three sizes, medium, small, and large. If we select the small size, the heat map will show a lot of purple, indicating that the jeans are too small for the mannequin. Similarly, if we select the large size, we can tell even without the heat map that the jeans are too big. When we turn on the heat map, it shows all white, indicating virtually no tension. Now let's take a look at this dress. I've attached our heat map component blueprint to the dress garment component, and we can see the heat map for this dress. Just like the jeans, we can select the small size for this dress. When we click play, we immediately see that the dress shrinks. If we turn on the heat map, we can see a lot of red and purple, indicating that the dress is too tight for this size. When creating garments for virtual fitting, you will need to adjust the stretch resistance of your materials. Typically, elastic materials have lower stretch resistance, while harder fabrics or parts of the garments that consist of multiple layers, such as jeans waistbands, will have higher stretch resistance. Let's explore how we can use override materials or native UE materials with heat maps. If we are not using heat maps with uDraper materials, we can undo our changes in the wrinkles material layer. Now we have a native UE material and will use the material override. Please refer to our tutorial on how to use override materials linked in the description to this video. We'll open the material and add the material function call node. We want to call our MF heatmap function here. Make sure that the show engine content and the show plugin content are enabled, so we can find our MF heatmap function. Then, for this demonstration, we'll connect it to base color. Surely you can always create something more advanced in your application. Let's play the level and turn on the heat map. The tension is visible, but we need to decrease the metallic effect. After doing this, we can see the stretched areas clearly. And here is an example of how you can use the heat map in the sequencer. We hope you found this tutorial helpful.